So coronavirus is a group of viruses, a family of viruses. They have their big RNA viruses. They have actually some of the biggest RNA genomes of any virus. They predominantly cause respiratory disease in humans. Right now, all diagnostic testing is being sent to the state public health labs and being coordinated through local public health authorities, and also being sent to the CDC. So right now, we don't perform clinical testing because that's supposed to be done by the public health authorities. But in the case that there is more transmission, we have to be ready for that because it does take a little bit of time to get these things up and running. Our clinical virology lab is one of the best clinical virology labs in the US and the world for diagnostic testing. And so, you know, for us, we're actually very good at this in terms of bringing on a new QRT-PCR test. We can ramp this up relatively quickly, as I said, in sort of weeks to about a month. And so we're ready, you know, for these things all the time. We had to do this with Zika. We had to do this for enterovirus D68. We've had to do this with 2009 H1N1. We're kind of hustling. We're doing as fast as we can to have that up and ready. And then we'll closely monitor all the genomics and work that's coming out to make sure that the primer designs and how we make our assay will work. The virus isn't evolving in a way that would complicate that. The other thing, it's perfectly okay to wear a mask. You know, it actually significantly reduces respiratory virus transmission. And then the other one is just sort of respiratory hygiene, washing your hands all the time and coughing into your sleeve, and if you're sick, stay home. You know, don't go out and circulate and spread the germs around.